Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to drop the basic bodies. Let's go! These are the tools needed: tape measure, pencil, ruler, French curve, and pattern paper for the material. Let's proceed! For this pattern, you need 1/4 sheet of Manila paper for front and back bodies. You have to fold it into two. So let's start with step number 1. Draw a perpendicular line and mark the corner A. So A is the starting point. From point A to get point B, measure 3 inches downward. So that is point B. Then A to C, measure 5.5 inches. So that is the chest height. And then A to D, you need to get 1/2 of the armhole. So example, armhole is 16 divided by 2, that is 8 inches. So that is point D. From point A to locate point E, use the figure length. Example, the figure is 15.5 inches. So always start with point A. So that is point E. Project point B, C, D, and E to the right with a straight line using ruler. A to F, use 2.5 inches for the neck width. So that is A to F. And then connect F to B using ruler. Using a French curve, you can shape the neckline. So the position of the French curve is look like a letter J. Point A to G, use 1/2 shoulder measurement. Example, the shoulder is 13 inches divided by 2, so that is 6.5. So that is point G. G to H, downward, measure 1.5 inches. So that is point H. And then draw a straight line downward. Connect F to H with a diagonal line using ruler. Next step is to locate point I. So from C, going to the right, use 1/2 chest measurement. Let's say chest measurement is 11.5 divided by 2, so that is 5.75. So that is point I. Connect H to I with a diagonal line. To get point J, start from point D to the right. Use 1/4 bust measurement. Let's say bust measurement is 31 inches divided by 4, that is 7.75. And then add 1 inch to the right. So that is point J. Next, shape the armhole using French curve from point I going to point J. Next is point K. From E to K, use 1/4 waist measurement. Sample waist is 25 inches divided by 4, that is 6 1/4, plus 1.5 inches for the dart, so that is point K. Connect J to K with a diagonal line. From line A to the right, get the bust height. Sample bust height is 8 inches. Measure it downward. To get point L. To get point M, start measuring from point E, use 1/2 bust distance. Example, bust distance is 7.5 divided by 2, so that is 3 3/4. So that is point M. From point M to the left, measure 3/4 inch. So that is point N. And then from M to O, another 3/4 for point O. Make sure that the distance of point E to M is the same as the distance of L from the left. Let's say the measurement is 3 3/4. Move it upward for point L and measure it also 3 3/4 to make it the same. Connect L to M and L to N, also L to O, using ruler. If you will see, our front bodice is almost done. But you need to finish it by connecting the dart for the waistline. All you have to do is fold the dart. By folding point O going to point N. Then connect E to K with a straight line. So it's very important to connect it and make it straight so that it will not have a notch. So it's very easy if you follow the step-by-step procedure, and you can do it by yourself. So let's move on to the drafting of back bodice sloper. So to draft this, you need another 1/8 sheet of Manila paper that you folded a while ago, and then place 2 tracing papers in between so that you can transfer the drafted back bodice. To drop the back bodice sloper, you need to use the front bodice as a guide to make it easier. To start with, from point A downward, measure 1 inch to locate point 1. So that is the depth of the back neckline. And then shape it using French curve from point F going to 1. To get the back shoulder, you need to raise 1/2 inch from point H to get point 2. And then connect F to 2 with a diagonal line. To To get the back arm hold, measure 1/2 inch from point I going to the right to locate point 3. To get point 4, from point J to the left, measure 1/2 inch. And then from point A to the left, measure also 1/2 inch to get point 5. Connect 4 to 5 with a diagonal line. Shape the back armhole starting from point 2, passing to point 3, going to point 4 using French curve. Now let's proceed to the dart of the back bodies. So start from point L upward, measure 1 inch. So that is point 6. Then from M going to the left to get point 7, measure 1/2 inch. Get point 8, measure again 1/2 inch. Connect point 6 to point M with a straight line. And then point 6 to point 7. And then point 6 to point 8 for you to have the back dart. So this is now our back bodies. So to complete these back bodies, you need to fold the dart by connecting point 8 going to point 7. And then, using your ruler, draw a straight line from point 5 going to point E to make the waistline straight. So it's done. So to transfer the back bodies, you need to trace the markings. So you will start from A going to E and then all red lines. Using the tracing paper, you transferred all the lines of back bodies. And to make it clear, you just trace it again. This is our back body. So this is point 1, point 2, point 3, point 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Again, fold the dart by connecting point 8 to 7, then draw a straight line from E to 5. are through with drafting the front and back bodies stopper. Always remember that these are only basic or foundation patterns that comes from the exact body measurements and can be used to make a style